Let's head over to Patrick Little.
All right, thanks, Ben. Kevin Gaudreau from the Pier Restaurant in Newport is here. Kevin, good morning. And you're going to make the crispy whole fish.
Correct.
Now, before we get started, I know we've got a camera up here somewhere. There's a full stripe or baby striped bass?
Yeah, it's a hybrid striped bass, 1.5 pounds.
Okay. All I can think about is that commercial, give me back that filet of fish.
Exactly.
That one's not going to start talking, is it?
It might. I can't guarantee it.
And you caught that this morning?
Yes.
All right. Tell me about the ingredients for the crispy whole fish.
Sure. We've got a little ginger, galanga root, some lemongrass. This is a Thai-based dish. A little plum sauce, rice wine vinegar, a little soy, a little mirin. Quickly, going to saute all those together, and then we're going to deep fry the fish with a little flour. It's a real quick presentation. It looks spectacular. It tastes great. Pairs up a lot of great wines.
So you do it, it's the whole fish. It's the whole thing.
It's the whole fish.
And you just use bass, or can you use any kind of fish?
You can use any kind of fish, you know, between a pound and 2 pounds. 1.5 to 2 pounds is the best size. Takes about 7 or 9 minutes to cook it. And what happens is it kind of blisters up in the hot oil, and then it just kind of falls off the bone. So it's a spectacular meal.
Popular dish down at the Pier Restaurant. Tell me about some of the other items down there.
Yeah, the Pier Restaurant, we're doing some creative twists on some seafood, but we also have some great classics. If you want to have a fish and chip or a lobster thermidor, we have those available too. So the menu has got a great variety of items there, so come on down and check us out.
That fish is not going to move.
Nah. Well, I can't guarantee it.
All right, Kevin, good to meet you.
Thanks.
More from Kevin in the kitchen from the Pier Restaurant coming up in a little bit. Back to you guys.
All right. In there. It is. There is some fish swimming around in here, but I have to tell you, what's really nice is the flavor is so wonderful, and you just get the essence of the ocean. You're not getting like a, you know, of course, a good fish shouldn't have a fishy smell, really.
Correct.
So it's
Correct.
It's really great. Here's the other thing that I love. I you guys caught me because I was just reading the takeout menu. My favorite thing in the whole world is when I can go to a really good restaurant and then grab something for lunch or for dinner that you guys make, and then maybe pretend it's mine, pretend I made it. I mean, I don't know if I can. We'll see if I can actually
do this.
You think?
By the end of the show, you're going to be able to do this.
Because it looks really fancy. It looks
very
like
simple.
All right. I'm going to have to see. I'm going to have to trust you on that. Now, here's the thing. I've been to the Pier before and loved it, but you guys have since done a renovation. Tell me a little bit about what you guys did.
Sure. The current owner is Peter and Harry. They acquired the restaurant the end of last year, and they wanted to kind of bring it back to its original glory, which is, you know, they put some time, some effort. We put a great menu together, great front-of-the-house staff. Charlie Holder is our general manager. He did a great job putting there's our bar and lounge right there. Put a great crew together to service all our guests and, spruce it up a little bit. There's one of our views right off our patio.
That's stunning. Yeah. That is really beautiful. And I tell you, when the weather starts getting like it is today and like it was yesterday, you guys must be hopping.
Yeah, it gets a little crazy. We have the St. Patrick's Day parade on Saturday.
Oh, fine. So, that's right. That's right.
That should be fun. We're looking forward to that.
Well, the pier is the restaurant, and it's at 10 Howard Wharf. In just a moment, we're going to cook this whole fish, which seems kind of intimidating, but I'm told we can do it.
Very so simple.
We'll
Very
see what
simple.
Happens. We'll be back in here in just a moment. Back over to you guys.
All right,
welcome back to the Roadshow Kitchen. We've decided that Patrick is going to go out and fish for me. And then cook that fish for me.
Oh, really?
All I have to do is eat it. If I did want to cook it, you're going to show us how.
Yes. What you want to do is you want to put some cuts into the side of the fish like this to help it cook quicker.
Yeah. Okay. Like you do with the hot dog.
Exactly.
Lines in it.
Yeah. I boil mine.
What you want to do is you want to coat this in oil real quick like this.
Okay.
And this is going to help blister up the skin.
In flour,
this
you mean. There was no oil,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Before it goes into the oil, you want to hit it with the flour.
Okay.
Now, stand back because I don't know where this oil is going to go.
Here we go. Everyone.
Splash guard.
Here we go.
Oh, my hand!
No.
Oh,
look how the talent is far away from the actual action.
Here's the talent.
We're good right here.
We're the host.
Look at this. All right. While the fish is cooking, the fish is going to be about seven minutes that fish will be done. You want to have a hot saute pan. We're going to make a quick sauce right now.
Yeah, what kind of oil is that?
That's just like a canola.
Okay.
So it's around 350 degrees. You want to? This is a pumice oil that I'm cooking with. Don't touch that. That'll be real hot.
Good call.
You'll be screaming.
Good call.
I'm going to put a little ginger.
Okay.
A little galanga root.
What?
Which is
a little what?
This is called galanga.
It's very looks like ginger.
It's very similar to ginger, but it has more of a citrus overtones.
Can I try to eat it?
It's kind of hard. It's very stemmy.
I'm also
going to put some lemongrass in here.
Oh, but it's very, very strong.
A lot of flavor in there. And you'll notice in Southeast cooking, they just quickly saute it up.
That's good, too, before you go on a date.
A little garlic?
Yeah.
Wait,
a
couple weeks ago, I went to a yoga class. I had garlic the night before. I felt so bad for the guy next to me. It was coming through the pores.
Yeah.
It was awful.
I just want to let this kind of sweat down a little bit. I'm trying to get all those different flavors
sweat
into
down.
The pan. You can see it's sweating right now.
Yep. Now, cooking with this whole fish, is that a traditional Asian way of cooking fish?
Definitely, Southeast Asia, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, they do a lot of this kind of cooking.
And even in the Mediterranean, too, right?
Yes. In the Mediterranean, they like to do it more of like an oven roasted or on the fire, something like that. Extra virgin olive oil, a little garlic or rosemary.
We're the only ones who like to not know that it was actually had a face.
Exactly.
Now, what about but people like skin the fish before they eat it usually because they get the scales off and all that. This, obviously, you're just throwing it right in there.
This fish is actually, it's been scaled.
Okay.
Because you can't eat them. It's a scale.
It's probably not very pleasant on the way out.
Yeah. Talk about that date with the garlic and stuff.
Right.
Okay, scales are gone, all right. Yep.
What I want to do now is I want to kind of deglaze this a little bit. This is with mirin, which is like a seasoned rice wine.
Okay.
Okay. We're also going to add in, this is a little plum sauce. So it's got a little sweet and spiciness to it.
Where can the plum sauce you can get just at in a
you can get it at
Ethnic Foods Market?
Any supermarket. You can get it anywhere nowadays.
Okay.
If you go up on Broadway, there's some great Asian markets up there, though, and you can get all that. That's not coffee. That's soy sauce.
I was going to take a sip.
You can take a blast if you want.
Yeah, all right. You get a straw?
No, straight out of the cup.
Straight up.
This is a little Mai Ploy, which is like a Thai ketchup. So it's roasted red peppers and chilies and garlics.
Are you going to use this, or can I just?
I'm actually going to put just a touch of that.
I want to feel involved.
All right,
there you go. You are involved.
You handed it to him. That was great, Patrick.
A little soy. This is going to add the salt element to this dish.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Beautiful. So we're just going to let this reduce down. It's almost done.
And just kind of thicken up, and that'll be the sauce to the fish,
this
right?
This is going
to
be the sauce for the fish. What you would do is let it simmer for about 10 minutes, and then you would strain it through a chinois or a strainer or something like that to get out all those root bed. The lemongrass, the garlic, the ginger, the galanga.
Now, how do you choose what fish to use? I mean, if you have bass, great, but what kind of, I mean, you wouldn't do flounder like this, right?
You could do any kind of fish this way. But the reason why we pick these kind of swimmers is because they stand up nicely on the plate. Where a flat fish or something like that, sit on the plate.
A little less presentation.
It kind of takes away from the presentation.
Gotcha.
When people go out to dinner, they like to get that wild.
Well, speaking of presentation, let's bring this over.
Sure.
And so then you kind of take the fish out, put it here. You put the sauce that's kind of reduced here.
Yep.
And a little bit of parsley.
We have a little cilantro. Cilantro is got a great little flavor. It marries well. We also have some spun carrots.
Oh, I'm going to try it.
I will.
Now, what about that? There's the head of the fish over there and the mouth and the eyes. You don't go near that, do you?
You can eat all the way up until the gills.
There's bones and things up there.
Yeah, there's bones throughout the whole fish.
Right, but I mean, isn't there more stuff up there that you're not supposed to eat?
No, you could actually, you'd be surprised what people eat these days.
Yeah, I have kids.
But you could eat that whole fish.
Okay.
Obviously, the bones you wouldn't, but... You see how it just kind of flakes right off?
Wow, look at it. Just falls right off.
I got a bone. That's lucky.
It falls right off the...
It falls right off the carcass.
Fine. The carcass? Yep. Yep. Carcass.
Oh, man, that's really good. It's so flavorful. And you just eat the skin as well.
Just like that. Yeah, it's like crispy skin.
Oh, my gosh, I love it.
Ooh.
Right? Isn't that good?
Very good.
Surprisingly good and sweet with a little bit of a kick, right?
You don't eat this, though, do you?
You'd be eating it for a little while, but you could try it.
No, I'm good.
You're good. No. So that's it, crispy whole fish. A lot of different flavors going on there. Pairs well with a white wine or a light red. So, come on down and try it.
Yeah, the Pier Restaurant in Newport. And I tell you what, Michelle, today's a great day to get down to Newport, in fact.
Oh, they had a beautiful weekend. I was down in Newport over the weekend.